Hello, sir. Just 2 minutes. Earphones, this is okay, or you have some good earphones? Got it removed? All right.
Better now. They not able to come. So,
they're asking admit. No, I can admit. No, people.
That is right.
Slowly English. I'm very fast speaking. There's another problem. I just started screen sharing. We can stop it now. What is that? Admitted, huh? This guy. Press escape. As of now, admit. Another fourth guy. How will I know who are all their participants? Gallery. All will come here. Bhargavi. She's a chartered accountant. Yeah, can you hear Bhargavi? I can't hear her.
You can't hear?
I can't hear her. Bhargavi, can you hear me? No volume. Okay, voice. Can you hear me now, Bhargavi? Okay, is enough? Because most of them are, the group is from Nigeria, so they were asking me to speak very slow English. So I'll be doing. Welcome. We can just put them, so people can read. The PowerPoint it is there. All right. Now participants I cannot see, no? But I can't. This is the first line. No, this one. No, no, no. I'm not doing this. Pardon? Oh, is it? Oh, they'll not be able to visit. See, oh. Okay, cursor. Oh, okay. So this. Okay. Now, I want to hear from them whether they're able to, audio is clear or not. Can Bhargavi, can you talk so that I can listen?
Yes, uncle. Yes. How are you, uncle?
Oh, great. Super. So, how are you doing?
Thank you for inviting for the meeting.
No, good most to see of you. Most of the masala is already sent to you. Everything is there. A little bit of brushing up.
Okay. Thank you.
The beauty is, see, everybody knows everything. It's not that people don't know it.
The only thing is the problem in following.
Not like that. See, I always look at it. They see knowledge. The doctors are totally knowledgeable, but they're also sick. Despite knowing, doctors are suffering with various lifestyle diseases. Very strange.
Yes.
You know the reason for that? Despite knowledge.
You're right.
Practice. All along, I was thinking knowledge alone is important, but no. Good, great. How is your daughter?
Good, uncle. Good.
Excellent. So, how you taken time off
so
from your?
Is Raghava.
Yeah, hi, Raghava.
Hello. From your,
how are you? Hi. Good to see you. This is my first meeting. I wouldn't be knowing. I have my friend Venkat to help me.
Okay.
Good. So others have learned. You know? Other participants can also interact so that we know.
All the other are muted their audio and stopped their video.
Okay. They're only listening. Wonderful. Okay.
Yes.
So that
yes.
There is no disturbance. So what's the time?
Yeah, of
now?
Course. But
another 6 more minutes to go.
Yes.
Shravanti. Shravanti, no, the teacher. I think so. Today, Chennai, we have a total lockdown.
Oh, okay.
So you can't go out on the bike and all, they'll catch.
Okay, not even in the morning for groceries.
No. Today, no groceries. Everything is absolutely standstill.
Oh, okay.
Because Sundays only the corona will be moving around. Other days they won't. Very strange.
Okay.
Very strange.
So here is another participant. You can interact with that.
Good evening, Master.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah, I'm doing good. Thank you. How about you?
Super.
Yeah.
So, good to see you. Muted.
Started or it will start?
Yeah. So audio is clear, no?
Yeah, it will be clear.
Because since I am conducting this first time, I have no clue. So I have got requested a friend of mine to help me out so that it doesn't get bungled up.
No problem.
Hi, your daughter, huh? Where is your
son? Yes.
Hi, Ma. Who are you? You are very cute in photos.
Hello, Nartatya.
Hello.
Super.
Sorry, Dhruv will pay it on.
Dwarak, Dwarak has gone. Dhruv is here.
Dhruv
is here. Oh, Dhruv is not gone.
Okay.
That's after the participant joined, we can start off. So we wouldn't be knowing. You're able to see the presentation, the first slide?
Yes, able to see.
No, not the presentation is not showing up, uncle.
Is it so? I already
started.
No, I've just put a slide.
Yeah.
Too busy for improvements.
Consistent.
So the guy who is pulling the cart is my son. And the other guy is my nephew. They don't want to listen anything. They will do their own. You see, look at that square wheels. They want to struggle like that life. I hope my son is not listening. It's a wonderful poster. See, it talks everything in one beautiful thing. I have not been able to understand people who definitely need, this sort of knowledge, they're not interested. I don't know the reason why. Many of them. I saw one guy was weighing 120 kg in a vegetable shop. So I was interacting with him. I've shown him the photographs, how people are getting easily benefited. Yeah, uncle, he said, but nothing. So what would be the reason? People, why are they not interested in taking care of their own health? I don't know.
Many you people, only told, no. We are too busy.
Yeah, of course. Everybody is busy. True.
So anyway, we should thank you that you are at least letting us to know the things. We are getting time to at least to listen to the things.
True.
After some point of time, it will be injected into our brains and we will start somehow.
True.
If people like you are not there, okay. So we don't even listen to that. We don't even look at that.
True, I agree. See, at times, one particular single point can transform our life and change our approach. I tell you, I used to be a non-vegetarian eater at least weekly 4 or 5 times and all that. And coffee, tea, about 5 or 6 times. One class I attended, when I listened to that, that's the day I stopped. It's about now 20 years, 2000. Coffee, tea, alcohol, non-veg, everything I stopped at one go. The class was over in the afternoon. The teacher was having his tea. But I stopped. And it's 20 years now. I have not touched anything. So I wanted people also to just transform themselves and become more lively and enjoy their lives.
Good evening, Nangasara.
Hello, Nangadra Garu. Namaskaram, sir. Good to hear you. See you. Wonderful.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your enterprising.
There is no enterprising, sir. I have a very, very focused, sharing to the people. Many people think I'm a pest, P-E-S-T, pest, because I chase people. I sit on their head, dance on them. I've entered. Oh, I have to go to waiting room and see. Yeah, then I'd be admitting. Total 17 participants. No, as of now. People can keep joining in between also, no? Oh. Okay. Thank you. Okay. But people who come late will miss out that introduction and all that. No, can't help it. True. I think names will come, huh, like that.
You can record it and send it later on.
Yeah, yeah. But almost some 15 minutes, the earlier thing got recorded. Can we disconnect that and start recording again?
No. From now onwards, you can record.
No, it was recording from the beginning. So can we redo it? Can we do something?
Hello.
Hello.
Only up to 45 minutes,
sir. Yeah. 45
minutes. Turn off. Yeah, hello. I'm Dr. Viola from Nigeria.
For you, good afternoon. For us, in the evening.
Yeah.
Good to see you.
Yeah, good afternoon, good evening.
And I must compliment you, the work what you're doing in your country. Amazing.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
I'm very pleased.
Thank you so much.
We have met at a program in Vijayawada and she has done a phenomenal job. Amazing. Now, how many of group people are there, madam, in your group?
Okay, let me check.
Not the ones who are participating. I'm just saying our group.
Oh, yeah, we are above 150.
Wonderful. Only one group as of now.
Yes, only one group.
I think you start posting some success stories like I keep sharing you.
Yes.
Because that will motivate, you know, that will energize people.
Yes.
Hello, sir.
Namaskar. I'm not
able to. Good evening.
Pandi, how are you? Good to see you, Pandi.
Fine.
Great.
How are you, sir?
Great, super. Mute padale. You lost some weight, yeah? You're looking smarter. Good, keep it up. Your grandson. He is muted, no? That's why that's you. Yeah. Good evening from India. And my name is Gangeshwar Rao. So I live in Chennai. I'm 62 years old. And you may be wondering what qualification I have to talk about this subject. Basically, I'm an automobile engineer. And I worked in a company, construction equipment, for about 34 years. I've retired 4 years ago. But a few years ago, up to 2014, I had been having a lot of health problems. I'll just show it to you. So if you see this photograph in 2014, I had been having about 10 medications and using medications for diabetes, blood pressure, and then cholesterol, BP, and some joint pains also. So, and what was happening is that a lot of medication, and okay, I'm comfortable, energetic and all that, but you know, that was really taking me a toll. So I happened to know a person called Dr. Manchana Sachinan Raju. I think this Nigerian group is fully aware of that particular doctor. And he has been doing a fantastic job last 28 years. He's been spreading the knowledge. He's going and giving lectures at his own cost. And his books are printed on various health subjects. And I happened to buy a book of 70 rupees book, How to Get Rid of Diabetes Without Medication. So I started reading that book and I was amazed to see the approach. Then I started following it from January 2014. In a span of 4 months, I was only hoping to get rid of my diabetes. But surprisingly, I find that I've lost my weight, about 9 kg weight, and I've become absolutely fit and comfortable. And when I have gone to my doctor after 4 months with my blood reports, I didn't go with the reports, I got basic reports and gone. The doctor was surprised. He says, yeah, you should not stop diabetic medication. You should not stop cholesterol medication. You should not stop BP medication. You are getting into trouble. I said, fine, doctor, let's all the tests be done at your lab. So he has done all the tests. I spent about 3,000 rupees at that time. And then after seeing all the reports, he started typing a prescription for me on his laptop. Then he pulled out a paper and gave it to me. It was only one medication was there. I told doctor, I have already discontinued all medication and I have no desire to take any medication. He said, Mr. Rao, I cannot take empty paper from the printer. I have to type something. So I'm giving a multivitamin tablet. If you're interested, you can have, otherwise you don't need it. So that is my own personal experience. And then what I've been doing last 2014, I've become passionate. I'm very thorough on automobile engineering. I know everything about vehicles and hydraulics and transmissions, but I don't know anything about this body, which is a miracle body. And I realized that, look, I have really neglected to understand the body, how it functions. Once you understand how it functions, you can take care of it well. So if you all know, when you buy a car, a diesel car, the manufacturer tells very clearly where to put diesel, where to put engine oil, what to do, what not to do. If you do accordingly, you will get a better performance. If you don't do it, your vehicle will not give performance. Dr. Vaila, you're able to hear? Is the speed okay?
Can anybody? Yes.
Is it audible, clear? The speed is all right?
Yeah, acha.
Acha, very good. Fine. So last about 6 years, believe me or not, I spent at least 3 to 4 hours in understanding on health. Go through the YouTubes, read books, plenty of books, and look at the contradictions. There are a lot of contradictions. If you see in YouTube videos, one fellow says, if you don't take salt, you will get into trouble. Another fellow says, if you take salt, you will be in trouble. Like that. Somebody says, don't drink water. If you only drink water when you're thirsty. Another fellow says, you must drink 4 to 5 liters water. So how do we get around these contradictions? So I've tried to do a lot of research. So I didn't believe. Can somebody mute that sounds, please? Somebody is talking.
Is it possible to mute everybody?
Can we mute from here? 1 second, let me check. Yeah.
Most have an option. You can mute everyone. Yeah.
Okay. We are just checking. I think so. Yeah, thank you. So pay attention. So what is needed is that about 3 to 4 hours I spend every day to understand, look at it, relook at it, question my own beliefs, and all that thing helped me in concretizing my understanding. Not that now I'm still don't think that what I know is the final or the best. I keep on scouting, keep on looking at it. So let me tell you, there are some references which I'll show you right now, some doctors. Can we just go down? Why is it getting longer? Go down. Look at the resources, what I have. Friends, let me tell you this. These are the resources I have, apart from the books. Dr. Manthana Satyana Raju is the best, I must say. I have gone through many of these people and he is the wonderful and the best. And fortunately, Dr. Vaila's Nigeria group is following that. I don't have to emphasize more on that. Then followed by the Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev, amazing person. You can listen to their videos. Then Veeramachin Ramakrishna is a new guy in India, in Vijayawada. He's doing an amazing job. People with 150 kg weight, in a span of 5-6 months, they're coming back onto the normal weight. He has a very radical diet, VRK diet it is called. It's basically more of fat. Then Dr. Stenberg, you can look at those names. Fantastic people. I must have listened to them many occasions and I find the best out of the lot. Most of them feel that the medication can only be used in emergencies. When you have an accident, if you have a emergency, only that time is medication is required. If you are on a lifestyle diseases, if you are going to follow medication, you are sure to get into more trouble. So that's what I would like to share with you people. So now I'm qualified in terms of sharing my understanding. You relook at it. So as I explained to you, now what is happening, because I have an experience of sharing with hundreds of people, out of that only handful people are take advice and take benefit. And there are many probably who have not acknowledged, but probably they'll be taking benefit out of this understanding. It's not a rocket science at all. Everybody knows everything, but I put it little streamlined way, which we will understand it subsequently. Probably today we will focus more on why we are getting lifestyle diseases. What, where is the criteria? Because once you know what it is, you can hit the, you know, problem very precisely. That's what it is. See, what is happening now is that people are unwilling to learn. People who are probably very obese, people having a lot of problems, they're unwilling to learn anything. You know why? The reason is it's very simple to pop a pill and do what nonsense you're doing. As long as you're doing that, probably there is no scope. That's why doctors tell you lifestyle diseases are not curable. You have to take medication lifelong. So that is only because of that. If you're willing to change, there are scope is there. Not getting the right knowledge. Again, the information what where many a times we feel whatever we know is the best. Some lot of people feel drinking milk is good. Taking non-vegetarian has got a lot of protein. Things like it. But is it true? We will look at it in separately. Now, not implementing what they have learned. So I was always asking a question. Except naturopathy doctors, most of the other doctors are always unwell. You look at the current doctors. Doctors have the problem of diabetes, by BP, there is an insulin, there are cancers and all that. But look at naturopathy doctors. They're all very healthy. I've seen people with 100 years, 90 years, 84 years, amazing health, because they follow the rule book of the body. We will look at it, what is to be done and all that. So this is what I explained to you, how I transformed myself in 4 months period. And last 6 years, I've been able to maintain my weight about 58, 57 and amazing health. Look at the blood pressure. I used to have 130 by 90 with medication. Presently, my blood pressure is 90 by 60. Many people think it's a low blood pressure. No, we will look at the slides little later. And this was the medication I was using, about 11 medications. And then fortunately, I got rid of it. Last 6 years, I didn't take any medication at all. And I don't think I need to see a doctor at all. Okay, this is another slide to just give you an idea. And this is another friend of mine who came in the group. And I was telling him, initially he was not interested. Later in a 4 months period, during this lockdown period, he was able to reduce a 20 kg weight and he shared his photograph. And he was telling me that, thank you, uncle, you've been able to give me right guidance. And this guy had done a wonderful job and everybody can do that. And look at this one. Today morning he called up and he said that everybody tells me that I'm looking weak. Incidentally, he's 82 kg. Everybody tells me I'm weak. And my boss, who is a Korean, he was suggesting me that I should take non-vegetarian. What should I do? I said, don't worry. You're 82 kg. You are not sick. How are you feeling? Are you feeling energetic? Are you feeling comfortable? That's what it is. So as long as you are feeling that, you don't bother about somebody's opinion. This is what I told this guy. There's one more person. He's from Hyderabad. He said, I've lost 10 kg weight, sir. It's in about span of... But 4 months again during this lockdown. And there are a few other examples are there. I don't want to waste time. Now let's look at it. Metabolic syndrome, causes and remedy. As I told you, gentlemen, knowledge and practice are the gateways to your health. If you don't have proper knowledge, you're not practicing that, there is no scope. If at home, I tell you, parents are responsible for their teenage children's health. Because whatever parents follow, they follow. You all must be knowing that when you go to your doctor, doctor tells you, oh, is it heredity? Your diabetes, your grandfather has got, yes. Your father has, yes. Your uncle has, yes. You also will have. No, it is not like that. What happens is that whatever grandfather mistakes he was doing, the same thing is followed by his son. So same habits, the habits are causing the problem. So we look at it. Let's look at it. What is metabolic syndrome? There are about five criteria. Increased waist circumference, belly fat. So look at it. If I see most of the places, ladies are not being shown as pregnant, but most of the male look like as a pregnant. Many of them. For some of them, probably the shirt buttons are very opened up. So that's how they're going about it. But they feel they're comfortable. There's no issue. But there is an issue. Increased waist circumference is the problem. High triglycerides, that will come out through the blood test only. Elevated blood pressure. Again, the blood pressure, if it is high, that is one of the cause, one of the reason for the, not one of the criteria for metabolic syndrome. High blood sugar, diabetes. Low HDL, that means good cholesterol, low cholesterol. So out of these five, if anybody has three of these problems, it is called a metabolic syndrome. I hope I made it clear. So let's look at each of us. Where are we? If you have high belly fat, somebody may be thin, but he has a protruding belly. That means he has got visceral fat, it's called belly fat. Other triglycerides come out of with your lipid profile. Blood pressure, you know very well. High blood sugar, a low HDL. Hi. Yeah, Bhargavi.
Yes, uncle. I was in car and I could not able to connect to you.
Okay, now back to connect it. Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, fine.
Yes, uncle, yes.
Yeah.
Just now got a connection again.
Good. Out of these five things, if anybody has got three, it is called metabolic syndrome. So now what is the importance of it? Why it happens? What is the reason? See, many of the people... hold it and okay. Let us look at the miracle human body. I call it as a miracle body. God has been so kind. God has been so kind that he has given a wonderful body. You can do any type of abuse for a longer period also, but still it supports you. It doesn't happen for an automobile. If an automobile manufacturer tells you when you bought a diesel car, if you put one day petrol, it won't work. But whereas the human body, whatever nonsense we do, it still functions. It's a great thing for the body. Let's understand, you guys have a greatest gift as a body. Please understand the body and pay attention. Body is made of approximately 40 trillion cells. 40 trillion cells. Each cell you cannot see with naked eye. Now let's look at it, what happens. Why diseases manifest, where it happens. Diseases manifest when cells start dysfunctioning. Why the cells dysfunction? Inadequacies in blood. What are the inadequacies in blood? One is toxicity. That means what is needed you are not giving. What is not needed you are giving. That is toxicity. Deficiency means what? What is needed you are not giving. Disuse means you are not using the body. Sedentary life. Let's look at it. Suppose you're making Indian people, we know sambar. For sambar, the ingredients are there. So whatever ingredients are required, you need to put them. If you put something else which is not required, what happens? It doesn't come properly. Deficiency means what is needed, you are not putting it. One is what is not needed, you are putting. Same in the body also. Let us look at what is not needed to the body. So many things. Alcohol is not needed to the body, right? Smoking is not needed to the body. But we are giving it to them. Deficiency means what? What is needed we are not giving. What is needed? You need vitamins. You need minerals. You need enzymes. Micronutrients. What happens when you cook the food? All these are lost. So once you start giving the right quality of food, then deficiency will be over. If you stop putting all nonsense, the toxicity is gone. Disuse means you are not using the body. Sedentary life. Once you start doing the exercise, all that. These are the three very important factors. We don't have to call this as a one particular problem. If all three, it's something like it. If you look at gold ornaments. If somebody is wears at the wrist, it is called a bangle. If somebody is wearing at the neck, it is called a necklace. But everything is gold only, right? Similarly, problems can be different. Somebody may be having a diabetes, somebody is having a obesity, BP. But the problems are these three. Once you address these three problems, I'm sure that you will be overcoming the problem. See, one has to abuse the body by frequent eating, more than 2 times every day, and eating processed junk foods, lack of nutritious food, and sedentary life, many years. It's not that you are doing it for a year or two. It must be 10, 15, 20 years. Until 20 years, the body supports. Can I have some water? Many years to get metabolic syndrome. So let's look at it, friends. Whatever time from today, let's take a whoa. Let's not put what is not needed to the body. Let's give the body what it needs and start exercising. Look at body has self-regulating, self-healing capability. Look at if an automobile got a crack, it requires a additional welding. Suppose you get a cut on your body, what happens? It cures itself. Such a capability the body has. If somebody breaks their bones, all that doctor is doing is just aligning it and making it not move. That's the reason it is healing. So what needs to be done is creating a healthy environment for healing. How do we create a healthy environment? We will look at it separately. Now we are looking at the reasons for the problems. If these three things are kept in mind, what is not needed, you are not putting in the body. What is needed, you are giving. You are using the body properly. Now let's look at it. What is this insulin resistance? Where the problem starts? How it happens? Let's pay attention to this. See, whenever you eat food, what happens? Blood sugar increases every time we eat or drink. It get digested and then it gets into your small intestine, absorbs it, and then it goes. The sugars go into the body. Body senses increase in blood sugar levels after eating. So once you finished eating, while eating itself, your sugar levels keep going up. So pancreas will detect that their sugar levels are going. Then immediately it starts releasing the insulin. It's a particular endocrine organ. It releases insulin. And then that's how it maintains the sugar levels. Sugar levels for anybody to be maintained between 80 and 20 milligrams per deciliter. It's very important. If it goes down, people can get into coma. If it goes up, then over a long period of time, they get into diabetes and other things and all that. So let's look at it, what is happening here. Eating or drinking, except water frequently, and too much refined carbohydrate cause high blood sugar levels. To control blood sugar, higher insulin levels are produced by pancreas. Over a period of time, 10 to 15 years, because of elevated insulin levels throughout the body in the blood, cells develop insulin resistance. That leads to metabolic syndrome. I'll give one some small example. If you are subjected to that for many times, let's look at an alcoholic. When a person starts consuming alcohol, in the first day, he takes a little quantity and he's really touching the roof. Over a period of time, and probably he finishes a full bottle, he doesn't get the same enjoyment or the kick what he has got it. It is because he had become alcohol resistant. Similarly, if you see a person who is working in a fish market, suppose they are subjected to the fish smell day in and day out. Over a period of time, they cannot even find that stinking smell. A new person goes there, he'll immediately find that smell is unbearable. But for them, it is all right. Same is the case for a flower seller. I was talking to a flower seller near my house. So she carries flowers and gives her such a fragrance to the lift. I asked her, do you feel the smell? She says, no, because she's been selling the flowers for the last 10, 15 years. But she can immediately smell a fish smell outside. It's like a fish lady can smell a fragrance like that. So this is what is called insulin resistance. More of anything. If I give one more example to you, if you like, say, a particular sweet, when you eat one sweet, you really enjoy it, you love it, and you like it more, you take second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, you'll say, no, I don't want it. Somebody offers seven, you say, get lost. Suppose somebody shoves eighth sweet in your mouth, you will vomit it. You got resistance. That's a shorter time, I'm telling you. So this is a very important thing you have to understand. See, human body is not designed for regular continuous eating or number of times eating. If you look at the ancestor, our ancestors, they either have a feasting or a fasting. Either they get plenty or they don't get anything at all for many days. So your human body is designed to handle both feast and fast, but not a continuous feasting. Every day we are feasting. Look at the modern generation. We have got all the facilities. Everything is available in the fridge. Everything you can order online. So everything you are getting it in a moment's notice. So that's how people have become habituated. Once you start habituated, then probably you will not be able to get out of it. Let's look what is happening here. Now, you're eating bad carbs. Bad carbs means refined food, sugars, like those things. Moment you eat more insulin is made. Then what happens? More insulin for a longer period of time. It's not one day, 2 days. Suppose you take a guy who is healthy 20 years and is a good habit. If he eats, suppose say 10 rasagulla also, 10 sweets also, you check his sugar level, he'll be normal. But a person who has advanced in age with a problem, probably in no time his sugar levels will go up. So cells will resist. Sugar stores as a fat. What happens? Now, many people think eating fat will increase the body weight. No, sugar. Sugar means whatever food you eat and it gets stored as a fat, and that's how one become obese. What happens is because of that, you become tired again. You eat bad carbs, you become tired and hungry. Watch out, people who are obese, they have got so much fat in the body, but they are hungry all the time. If they don't get the morsel within 2-3 hours, then again they feel very hungry. It will be compelling for them to eat. It is because of high insulin level. High insulin level make the guy hungry, make the guy to go for the food. Now what happens is that, here is a slide. I hope people are able to hear me, understand. Is it clear? Is the speed okay?
Okay.
All right, thank you. Now, what's happening here? The flattening carbohydrates. Flattening carbohydrates means refined food, refined sugars and all, and plus frequent eating, both are there. Drinking in the sense you're taking cool drinks or fruit juice, things like it, that is a drink. Except water, anything is a food, remember that. Many of people feel that, okay, drinking doesn't make a difference in the sense juice and all. Other than water, your entire digestive system has to work to digest it. So that means the cycle is started. Flattening carbohydrates, frequent eating causes increased blood sugar. Once the sugar level is going up, increased insulin will have to come and make it normal. Over a period of time, that leads to obesity. And you look at down, the insulin keep on increasing. That's how they become insulin resistant, and that will lead to diabetes. We look at it. Look at this slide, shows very nicely what happens. At the age of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, they're showing like that. Look at the blood glucose levels. So look at the blood glucose levels. Initial period within the range, as I explained to you, between 80 to 120 range, it is there beautifully. Is there beautifully. So it all depends. The more you abuse the body, maybe at the age 20. Nowadays, age 20, 25, people are obese. People are having diabetes and all that. Now look at this. So it's up to here, up to 30 years, he's just going beyond that limit. Then he started increasing the weight. Look at this one. At 40, he's already crossed the sugar levels and he's got into the diabetes. By the 50, he's a full-grown diabetic and obese. Look at the progress of it. All reason is the sugar levels are going up. Many people think that I am not having any sugar, sir. I'm all right. No, we'll look at in the next slides. Checking sugar alone is not right. What needs to be done is different. See, look at it. This yellow color, what you're seeing is the sugar level. 90 is the sugar level, and this is the insulin level. initial period both are very good, excellent, they are doing very well, and in about 8 years time his insulin level has jumped to 3 times, but your sugar levels are maintained. Look at it, the beauty of it is here he has already started the insulin resistance, but it is not known in the sugar level. And look at after 15 years still, if he goes to a doctor and he does the blood sugar test, he's got 94, he says excellent, but look at his insulin levels, he's already 15, it's about 5 times. And our 20 years down the line, he's got into a severe insulin resistance, we'll see in the next slides, and his sugar levels have gone up dramatically. Unfortunately, most of these doctors are only checking the sugar level, fasting sugar and PP sugar, and they declare the people that you are all right. It is not. The insulin level is very important. Let us look at it this way. What does insulin does? Insulin controls the sugar. So you are taking a parameter of a sugar, which is a controlled parameter. Something like if somebody asked me, what is the temperature in Chennai? So I'm saying he's sitting in this AC room and I say it's like 18 degrees. It's a controlled temperature, but outside temperature is different, isn't it? That's how it is. We need to check what is outside temperature and what is the inside temperature. Suppose the outside temperature is say 40 degrees centigrade and inside temperature 18. How it is possible? By the AC. AC is doing its work, it's controlling. Probably at that time if the temperature is 50 outside, maybe the AC consumes more power and it has to work hard to bring the 18 temperature. Same way. Your insulin levels are going up, but your sugar levels are controlled. Unfortunately, many of the doctors, either they knowingly do it or they don't know, I don't understand. They check only the sugar level and certify the people you are all right, which is not. This is an important aspect we need to keep in mind. Look at it here. This is an excellent slide. Now, see, if you see on the left side, you're insulin sensitive. And you have got excellent health and longevity. That means you live longer. And this side, it is showing insulin resistance, chronic diseases. So where are you? This is what it is talking about. See, there are about three parameters, I'll tell you. Fasting sugar is one parameter which is checked by the most of the doctors. So if your fasting sugar is 80, that means you are in this level. And it is increasing to from 80 onwards, you are going towards this side. Like the arrow is showing this way, this way. So fasting sugar is a criteria. Next is fasting insulin. If your fasting insulin is between 3 and 5, you are here. And it is going above 5, you are going in this direction. HbA1c is one parameter which talks about 3 months average sugar. See, we are checking the sugar. Today I want to check sugar. Suppose previous night I didn't eat properly, my fasting sugar may be low. Same way, if I eat too many of sweets and go to the blood test, or accordingly my sugar level will be very high. So this fasting sugar alone, PP sugar alone, should not be the criteria to decide whether he is a diabetic or not. Fasting insulin test. Unfortunately, even when I was in US, my son, I took him for, he's a 32-year-old. I took him to the, we went for a general checkup. In his hospital, I requested the doctor to do the fasting insulin test. He says, no, it is not covered under insurance. Because why? Because they want, probably this medical fraternity or this drug industry wants you to get into the problem deep. You get into probably your neck deep or probably your nose deep. Then you realize it. Suppose you check fasting insulin well in advance, so you know what's going to happen next 10 years. So you can take care of it. So likewise, HbA1c is the 3 months average sugar. So if it is 4.8%, amazing result. 5.7 and above is means you have started pre-diabetic and diabetic and all that. Now there is a formula to work it out, insulin resistance. This is an excellent formula. This formula is insulin resistance is you have to take fasting sugar multiplied by fasting insulin divided by 405. This is a formula. So here, this case is insulin resistance is point sensitive is 0.59. Here he is going 1.5 and above. Now here you see here, if a person is below 1.5, is insulin sensitive, is good, and if it is increasing to 1.5 above, it is called mild insulin resistance, mild. And if it is above 3, it is called moderate insulin resistance, is severe insulin resistance. So these are the way we have to look at your diabetic levels. See, here is one chart is there. Actually, everywhere only this color is, this is shared in the medical books and all that. These two criteria is not there. I've added it for you to understand. What is the, what they're saying? Normal means what? If you have a HbA1c test is about below 5.7, as I explained to you. And sugar level is below 99. PP sugar, not at all needed, but anyway, it is there. It should be below 140, say, right? Now, pre-diabetic, that means before you are getting into diabetic, you are already into the trouble. So if it is above between 5.7 into 6.4, that is called pre-diabetes. Sugar levels is 100 to 125. PP is 140 to 199, right? And say if the, for diabetes, this is the red mark they have given. But this is a parameter which everybody is forgetting is checking the fasting insulin level. Fasting insulin should not be, should be between 3 and 5. That means you are sensitive. If it is above, means you are already started the problem. After 2 hours, it should be below 30. But if it is above 60, that means you are in trouble. These are the parameters, very important. Let me do tell you, friends, when some there are 4 blind guys to explain about an elephant. Suppose one guy catches hold of a tail and he say it is like a stick. One fellow goes and catches hold of the leg and he says it's a pillar, isn't it? So it has to be looked overall view. Somebody looking at a different angle, he can describe out the elephant fully. Similarly, these are the three, these two additional parameters are very essential that would help. What I have done, I got hold of all my relatives and friends and I have literally compelled them to get those tests done. And I made a study, which I'll show it to you. I think it is here, I'll show it to you. See, look at it here. How people are having, these are the age of the people. Can people can they see this one? Is it clear in the laptops? And look at it, what is happening. Healthy, there are only out of 11 people. I have 40 people records with me, but I've just only given 11. Just to give you a sample of good parameters and bad parameters and the worst parameters. And look at the weights. People are 81 kg, 82 kg, 88 kg and all this. Everybody has got a high insulin level. Look at their insulin levels. Sometimes their sugar levels are not important here. Look at their weight and their insulin levels. And this is called, see, this is where they stand in terms of insulin resistance. All right. So look at it. Now this is HbA1c. Now they are into diabetic, some of them are serious diabetic, above 7, and each person I have given it here. See, this person is pre-diabetic and obese, both combinations they have. There are only 2 people healthy there, and one guy is 21 years and another guy is 57 years, and there, but look at, he's got a little higher here. So pre-diabetic and obese, both are common. Look at here, diabetic and obese, uncontrollable, they're on medication. People can reverse all these problems by simple lifestyle modifications. So this is about 11 people. Some of the people who are joined us, their reports also with me, and looked at their levels, and we were helping them. All right. So we have seen this. So this is an important criteria. Fasting insulin has to be checked. Many places this facility is not there. If it is there, they are charging very high amount, but it is essential to get it done. And this is what how insulin should be there. See what, why insulin is needed in the system. Whenever high sugars are there, to bring it down. If you're continuously eating at regular intervals, then your sugar levels are going up and your insulin levels are going up. Over a period of time, you will develop insulin resistance, and that's how the insulin levels will go up. Here, look at it here. In the laboratories, if you, when you go to a laboratory, when they give you a report, they say up to 25, below 25 is all right, they say. Fasting insulin up below 25 is all right, which is very misleading. If you have above below 25, that means you are already in a serious trouble. It should be between 2.5 to 5 only. Such a variance. Only few laboratories are talking about it, 7, 8, but very few laboratories. after 30 minutes of eating, it lab is telling you 30 to 230 it can be there. But it should be below 60. 60 minutes, again, it is the same. It should be. After 2 hours, you should come back to 30. Look at it, normal insulin levels, how it's happening. After half an hour, after 1 hour, after 2 hours, after 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours. What happens when you eat food, your insulin levels are going up. And suppose after 1 year, again, you put one more load of food in your stomach, again, it'll go up. That's how it remains like this level. Look at this peak. This is a bad situation. This red one is a bad situation. This blue color is the right one. So over a period of time, after a span of five hours, it's come back to three. This is how it should be. That's why eating twice makes a huge difference for the people. The photos what I have shown to the people, there is no miracle at all. It's just eat twice when you're hungry and maintain the timings. In between, nothing to eat. Everybody can take this as a simple point. Eat only twice when you're hungry. And in between, just drink water, nothing else. Even coconut water or juice, nothing to be taken because everything is food. Once you're able to do that, nothing else. And just do 45 minutes walk. All this talk is absolutely not required if somebody is sensible just to follow this. Eating only twice in a day, timing your choice. Food, mostly your choice, but avoid the junk food. That's all. Such a simple technique. Okay, look at Dr. Manthana. He's giving the best techniques. We will look at it. What are the benefits of that separately? This is an excellent slide. This is done by one doctor in US. He checked the parameters. There are four people. The first is a normal guy. He's a highly insulin sensitive guy. He's below 1.5. The second guy, early stage insulin resistance. He's got a 2.55 resistance. Late stage insulin resistance, 4.34. I will explain to this. Diabetic. Diabetes means, friends, understand, there's already a pancreatic failure. Your pancreas has already gone onto the attic. It is not functioning properly. It is not producing the sufficient insulin. So that stage will happen only 15, 20 years later. So look at it here. In the first stage, his sugar levels, this is glucose levels, this is the insulin levels. So how they're beautifully going up like this. In the initial period, that means 0 year. Let's say 1, 2 years down the line. So his levels are perfect. His sugar levels are, look at it here. His fasting sugar is 92. Insulin is only 4. Remember, I was telling you below 5, 92 and 4. That's how he has got a fantastic insulin sensitivity. 92. After 2 hours, again, it is 80 and it is 10. I said before below 30, it is 10 only now here. Look at the second guy, early stage insulin resistance. This person has got sugar 94. 94 is a good one, but his insulin levels are already gone 2.5 times, 11. That's why it is maintaining. As I explained to you just now, if the outside temperature is 50 degrees centigrade, my AC has to work hard to bring it 18 degree temperature. Similarly here, to bring back the sugar level, you have gone up the insulin level here. It is 11. After 1 hour, it has jumped to 86. Look at it here, it is only 19. It is 86. After 2 hours, it has come down to 83. Now, after 2 hours, somebody eats again. From 83, it is going to jump again. So that means you are already in a higher scale. Look at the third stage. This is the third, late stage insulin resistance. That means already is pre-diabetes. He became pre-diabetes. Now look at his sugar level. He's just gone above 100, 110. And his insulin levels have jumped to 16, almost 4 times. And look at his PP insulin. After 1 hour, it has jumped to 39. Look at this guy, 19, where is 239? So he's already making his goose cooked. After 2 hours, it is 117. This is the level here. He is already late stage insulin resistance, pre-diabetes. Look at our champion, fourth diabetes, pancreatic failure. Now by the time his insulin capability has come down, it is only showing 7. Look at after 1 hour, it is showing only 35. That means it's already worn out. Friends, it's something like it. If you are given a job for 8 hours, every day you are working 8 hours and doing all your job, you'll be very comfortable. Suppose for a week, you are asked to do 24/7. What happens? You You get tired, isn't it? Similarly, your digestive system get tired because of your frequent eating and your junk foods. Over a period of time, that's why I'm saying God has been kind. He has given you the longest rope to hang ourselves. So you get into the trouble later. His PP insulin is also 54. So I'll just show you next slide where it will give you more clarity. Look at this. There are five stages shown here. This is a normal stage, second stage, third stage, fourth stage, fifth stage. Now look at it. This is glucose levels. Almost for a long period, see, almost up to this period, his sugar levels are maintained well. His insulin levels are perfect here, but it has gone up and it is bringing the sugar level down. There is a time comes. This is the time where probably you can be declared as a diabetic. Your insulin levels are going down, your sugar levels are going up. See, I had had diabetes for about 12 years and I was using medication and I was absolutely having no knowledge and no understanding. And I was just following the normal pattern of eating and having medication. So my pancreas have already gone into a big jump. Now I started last 6 years, I've been doing this particular process, controlling. My sugar levels are under control. But if I eat a lot of sweets for a period of time, my sugar levels will go up. That means what? I have not recovered fully. I have been able to manage it without medication. That's important. So these are the levels. People can, from here also, they can all come back, provided you make changes. Otherwise, you are going into the direction of this one, high glucose, low insulin. That's how doctor tells you to start insulin injections. You know the reason for the insulin injections. Once you start insulin injections, that means you have become a type 1 diabetes. What is the difference between type 1 and type 2? Type 1 diabetes is autoimmune disease. That guy's pancreas will not work properly. It doesn't produce insulin. They have to have insulin from outside. They don't have insulin resistance problem. But whereas type 2 diabetes is not a problem of pancreas. It is a problem of insulin resistance. Once you address the problem, you'll be able to overcome that. Oh, this is a different subject and blood pressure. But anyway, I just briefly tell you. See, this blood pressure, what is the ideal is this one, 90 by 60 and 120 by 80. This is an ideal blood pressure. This is if somebody has got pre-high blood pressure and high blood pressure. So this is my blood pressure. I've just put my reading here. I used to have one time about 130 by 90 with medication. Now it is 93 by 64. Amazing blood pressure level. That means what? I have the least resistance for my heart. It will be functioning absolutely comfortably. That's why. Now, how to achieve this? We will look at it. Many people think 120 by 80 is a normal blood pressure, but no. 120/80 is the beginning point for the problem. If you have 120 by 80 workout, what needs to be done? A quick recap on that. Causes of high blood pressure and remedies. I've given about 13 causes and how to overcome that. I think Mantena group knows everything. Dehydration. People drink hardly any water. They drink maybe 4 or 5 glasses a day, which is the worst thing to happen. At least 3 to 4 liters of water is a must. And high table salt. See, table salt, what we get in India is Tata salt. The worst thing to happen, it's a chemical stuff. Avoid table salt. But you can use minimum Himalayan salt. It's a rock salt. It has got all the minerals and all that. Many people say no salt diet. Use minimal Himalayan salt. These are the reasons. If you have dehydration, your BP will go up. If you use high table salt, you have high blood pressure. No salt diet. Look at this contradiction. Somebody says if you have salt, you have BP. Same guy, another guy is telling if you have no salt, there is a BP. Both are right. Why? Because using this table salt is the one which causes the problem. But of course, you don't take any salt. Like Dr. Mantana says, don't have a salt, lot of vegetables and all. To an extent, it is okay. But using a little bit of Himalayan salt will help. D vitamin. This is another interesting thing, D vitamin. Now, all of you know corona is affecting more people who has got D vitamin D deficiency. Very interesting thing. D vitamin, though it is available, especially for Nigerian people because of the dark skin, your absorption levels are very low. You have to stay long hours on the sun. And then white people, they have absorption levels are better. But surprisingly, the other day Dr. Manchana was talking. I think people who understand Telugu can listen to Dr. Manchana's talks, amazing talks. Every day there are about 5-6 talks on various subjects. There are two channels. One is Good Health, another is Manchana Miracles. Such an amazing knowledge he shares, about 10-15 minutes videos, amazing knowledge. D vitamin below 30 is a problem. People have got below 10 and all, they're bound to have immunity problem. Sedentary lifestyle, everybody knows, no exercise. Lack of sleep, that can cause the blood pressure. Lack of sleep also, I would like to tell you friends, sleeping means you need to sleep as per your body rhythm. Circadian rhythm, they call it. Only in the night you should sleep. Nights, people have, a lot of people work in the night duties and they sleep in the daytime, their health will go for a score. So it's necessary to sleep between 10 in the night and before 5, up to 5 o'clock. Ideal timing to sleep. 7 hours sleep is a must between 10 and 6 p.m. Then lack of sleep, distress. See, stress is important. Stress is needed to make you work. Distress is the one which causes the problem. What is stress and distress? Stress means, okay, I have to attend the program. I have to give a program. The stress is good so that your adrenaline goes up and you do things better. Distress means on a constant basis you have the stress. Friends, if you stretch your hand and hold a simple, say, ball, simple ball weighing probably a few grams, and if you keep that one for 1 hour, 2 hours, even that ball weigh more, isn't it? Similarly, any issue you are disturbed and you keep it in your mind, that leads to distress. So avoid that. Obesity, people who are having high weight, BMI 18.5 and 24.9 is good. If you don't have, chances are there. Fasting insulin, many people think how it related, we'll show that. If fasting insulin is high above 10, that can cause the high blood pressure. Alcohol and smoking, as you all know, nutrition deficient food, and then toxic foods. These are the 13. If you understand all these 13, you can reverse your blood pressure. My brother, you know, whenever doctor always says, no, it's better to have a tablet. That's how they're tuning the patients. Not necessary. Take care. Don't just because you listen to this talk and don't discontinue your medication. Keep watching. Follow these things. Over a period of time, your blood sugar, blood pressure will come to normals. Yeah, this we have explained to you how this insulin resistance is causing the obesity and diabetes problems. And important thing is you have to have your fasting insulin should be below 5, ideal. Your insulin sensitive should be below 1.5. If you're above 1.5, you're called insulin resistance. And HbA1c is another important parameter. It's a 3 months average sugar level. It should be below 5.4. Look at it here. What all insulin can cause the problem? So we think that look at it, a person can get a stroke because of high insulin level. High cholesterol can happen. High blood pressure is the cause of insulin. Fatty liver. See, fatty liver is the key for all the health problems. Diabetes, heart diseases, dementia, right? And block a stroke. All this is happening because of high insulin levels. High insulin body over a period of insulin resistance. If you look at it, 80% of all health problems are because of insulin resistance. So how to become insulin sensitive? As I explained to you, very simple technique. Eat to your satisfaction. Eat only twice. Enjoy your food. Avoid junk food and all that. Just do that. Don't eat when you're not hungry. That is the main criteria, because we all know what's happening. See, you go to somebody's place, somebody offers to you. You just take for the sake of some courtesy. Or you have some food, you don't want to waste it, you finish it. Or somebody is offering you, somebody showing a lot of affection. It's all absolute nonsense. I tell you friends, I tell my friends whenever I say, even your favorite god comes and gives his prasadam to you in between two meals, tell him thank you, keep it with you, eat along with your food. If that sort of sense, if anybody follows, nothing is needed. My friends, you just this for understanding only, you see next 3 months the amazing results. I'm not suggesting you to you starve yourself, you do the dieting, nothing, no such nonsense. Eat your comfort, eat your full, enjoy your food, avoid, I'll talk to you about 10 points in the next slide. As I explained to you, 80% is because of insulin resistance. So let's look at what is the 20%, where is the 20% coming from? Constipation, the mother of all diseases. So look at it here. Look at here. This is a healthy gut. All of you know how big intestine is constructed. See, big intestine, small intestine, this is stomach. This is a small intestine here, and it is connected to your big intestine. This is the big intestine. This is called one particular colon. Three parts are there. This is one part. Ascending colon, it is called. Ascending colon. This is called transverse colon. This is called descending colon. You have your rectum and all that here. So it's nothing but your waste basket. In your house, you have the waste basket like that. It's all stored with the feces. Now, what is happening is that it's important to go 2 to 3 times bowel movement in a day. At least 2 times is a must. What is happening? We eat 3 times a day, but many of the people go to the toilet only once a day. That means you have keeping a stock. Is it very precious stuff to keep a stock? It has to be exited. It's very important. People who are in the group with Dr. Vaila, with Dr. Mantina, amazing technique he has got. How to have easily twice excretion in the morning. We will talk about it in the next slide. So this is an important thing. Once your big bowel is empty in the morning itself, that means there is no toxicity happening in your body. Remember, friends, people who drink very less water, what happens? The body is very intelligent. You have given very less water to the body. You know what body does? It picks up water from your big intestine. That's how all the toxins go into the body, to the people. That's how people who don't drink water, they have a hard feces. They are very difficult to go to the toilet. Hydration is very important. We will look at it separately. Now here, look at it, how this is totally, after dinner colon starts, 1 hour no bowel movement. Somebody is having bowel movement every 2 days once or 3 days once. Look at how his complete big intestine got changed. It's very difficult. If I see in US, a lot of people have colon cancer. You know why? Because they don't have this particular clean habit of 2 bowel movements. Very important. Now, how to get out of this problem? A lot of people have gas problem. They have constipation problem, indigestion problem, and acid reflections and all that. All that can go off if you are able to have this thing. Now, let's look at it, what needs to be done. Enema is an amazing thing, my friends. In fact, I have kept one at my place in India and one at my US. My grandson is about 4 years old. So at times, if he has some difficulty, I just give him enema. Enema is a technique. I think most of the Dr. Mantina's group knows it. Enema box is an important, essential thing at home. And then how to go out about, suppose somebody has got a constipation problem, what needs to be done? Buy an enema thing, learn how to do the enema. Fasting for 2 days will help, and next is 1-2 day fasting will help. Important thing is hydration, 4 to 5 liters water every day. There's a technique how to drink water. Many of the people don't know. I had a kidney stone problem some time ago, and I was admitted twice in the hospital. But of course, fortunately, I came out in a day without any surgery or anything like that. And the doctor told me, no, you have to. I used to drink very less water. Hardly I used to drink 1-1.5 liter water all my up to year 56. So God has been so kind that he has not put me into the attic. So then the doctor told me that you must drink more water. I started drinking more water. But thing is, the technique, this Dr. Manchana explained beautifully. Remember, friends, when you drink water on an empty stomach, that means there should not be food inside. Within 20 minutes, the water gets absorbed in the system. Suppose there is some food already. That means you ate about, say, half an hour ago or 1 hour ago, and you drink water. The water remains with the food, and probably it will impair the digestion process also, and absorption will not happen.
So important thing is that you must drink water when your stomach is empty. Best thing is in the morning. And then before, if you drink water, just wait for 20-30 minutes before putting anything. Suppose I drank water and somebody offers me something, I don't eat next 20 minutes. This principle one should keep it in mind. Same thing, while eating you should not drink water. And then after eating, minimum 2 hours you must wait. Initially you find it difficult. Once you start practicing this one, this particular technique, if whomsoever are listening to this, take home this point. Drinking water, this simple technique, many of us don't know. We simply haphazardly drink, we eat and drink a glass of water, haphazard living, absolutely disorganized. Once we understand this, the benefit is there. So as I explained to you, this doctor told me it never helped me. Only after I started reading doctor book, as I explained to you, 75 rupees book I bought in 2014. A span of 4 months, I've reversed all my problems, all health problems. And I'm saving 1,800 rupees per month. Last 6 years, lakhs of rupees I saved. So I donated that money to Dr. Mantina when we were there for constructing one particular mud bath. A lakh of rupees we have donated there because he's a great guy. I must consider him as a god because he taught the best knowledge to everybody. Intermittent fasting is a very fancy word. They say in US up to 8 hours you eat number of times, no issue, but 16 hours don't eat. But that is not the best one. Friends, I keep sharing in between, you know, Dr. Dikshit, Jagannath Dikshit, amazing person. He's in Pune and he's been teaching people. I think lakhs of people are benefiting. I'll share that information also to you. His technique is simple. He says eat only twice when you are hungry, maintain the timings, in between don't eat anything. Nothing else, simple formula. Whereas in Mantina, there are over and above this, there are some excellent points are there which we will discuss now. Avoid toxic foods. This would help you. Anybody who had got constipation, all these problems, understand this, start following this. You sure get it. Anytime anybody needs a query, you're welcome to contact me. My number is available. I'll just share with you. I was talking about the next 20% in insulin resistance is the reason for 80% of the problems. 80% is the thing for 90% of the problems. That means what? If you have got, say, 100 problems, 80 problems are happening because of your insulin resistance, 80 problems. Only 20 problems are because of some other reason. That's what we were talking about it. Allergy, sensitivity, constipation, immune response, autoimmune diseases. They have nothing to do with the insulin sensitivity, but they are to do with your sensitivity and all that. For that, very important thing is that your constipation should not be there. Your bowel movement should happen very clearly. 2 times every day, one has to go to the toilet. Somebody is eating 3 times, at least 3 times should go. Doesn't happen. Practice that. There is a simple technique which I will explain to you in a nutshell. How this autoimmune diseases happens. See, the leaky gut, inflammation. Inflammation is the one. Internal inflammation is the causes the problem. It leads to sensitivities and autoimmune disease. It's like a vicious circle. Look at in US, so many people have autoimmune diseases because they have leaky gut, inflammation, sensitivities, all this put together to them. Main reasons are antibiotic tablets, genetics, stress, sugar, and some other issues. Now, I think I want to tell you about the body, friends. Adaptive physiology, they say. Suppose you have never walked on the barefoot on the ground. If you walk on the barefoot, you will not be able to. You'll become very sensitive. Suppose you walk barefoot for a few months, then you'll be able to run barefoot on the stones. What happens? The body adapts it. Body knows then you have a thicker skin under the sole, on the sole. Same thing is guitar. Somebody is playing guitar. Initial stages, he finds it difficult because his fingers will be paining. But over a period of time, his particular areas become very, very hard. So he'll be able to play the guitar very easily. Same thing, lift weights. Initial period, he will not be able to do once he develops the muscles and all that. High altitude, when you go to high altitude, your body gets adapted to that for the low oxygen. Disease means what is adaptation? BP, blood pressure is an adaptation. We are trying to control it. Very wrong. See, what is happening is your body is trying to manage. It is something like it, you can call it homeostasis, it is called. You look at it, know how your body's parameters are, your temperature. any given point of time, you go into hot area, cold area, your body temperature is 98.4. And your heartbeat, your inhalations, these are the parameters. So body is trying to maintain. Body don't want to die. Just because you're walking on the barefoot, it doesn't want to die. So it develops, it adapts. Likewise, all the diseases are nothing but adaptations. They are the symptoms. See, somebody has got high BP. What doctor is doing? He's trying to bring back to the normal level. And we are happy. We think everything is all right, hunky-dory. No. What is happening is you're creating a problem. See, why high BP is created? There are certain, say you have high cholesterol or you have clogged arteries. So you need to send the blood. So BP is needed. BP is not a problem. Reducing the BP is a problem. Over a period of time, with the medication, what happens? All these, you know, blood vessels will become elongated. It doesn't contract and elongate. So the problem, long-term usage of the blood sugar BP medications will lead to trouble. So you, the earlier you get out of the medication, the best for you. Friends, I think there is one detailed chapter is there, how to overcome this problem. I don't think we cover this with long hours. How much time is over? Okay, we have 7 more minutes. So we will... Oh, you've already crossed 7 minutes. Okay, we have already crossed time. So what we do is that I'll just give you the 8 simple techniques, which I will probably in the next session, if people are interested, we can go to the next session and we'll discuss in detail. Now, I'll just give you in a nutshell. I think this is mostly Dr. Manchana's approach. A little bit changes here and there. Only 10% changes, about 90% is Dr. Manchana. So whomsoever is following Dr. Manchana need not have any issues. Look at it, drinking 3 to 4 liters of water in a day is a must. Please write it on a rock. 3 to 4 liters is a must. Depends on the season, weather and all that. It can go up more than 4, but it should be 3 minimum. 4 can go up also depending on the situation. As I explained to you, don't drink water 20 minutes before eating, while eating, and 2 hours after eating food. This is a golden principle, my friends. Once you adopt this drinking water alone, probably majority of your problems will go off. Twice excreting in the morning, 2 bowel movements. It's a must that you'll be able to overcome your toxins and all that. Brisk walk for 1 hour a day, at least 45 minutes to 1 hour. This is what I'm saying, sedentary life. You have to find time. If you don't find time, you'll have to pay price. Pranayama, that is a breathing exercise. Now people tell for COVID and all also pranayama helps. 15 minutes of... 4th, look at friends, the food is not coming at all in the list. Look at where the food is coming. So food is not very important. See, many people think food gives energy. Do you think food gives energy? No, food doesn't give energy. See, when a child is born, he's so small and he's so... less weight, how is growing to 6 feet tall and probably getting about 80 kg weight? It is because of the food. Food is for the growth. From where energy you get it? Energy you get from the sleep and meditation. See, suppose you are made to work for 3 full days without any break. Again, I tell you, no, I'll give you more biryani. Will you be comfortable? You say, no, you want to sleep only. Sleep only gives the energy. So after the growth of, say, 25 years, once the growth is over, people don't need 3 meals a day. I would like to tell you there's one doctor, Dr. Edward. He's a 1901 doctor in US. His name is No Breakfast Doctor. He has done an amazing study there and he has cured a lot of diseases. He says, don't have breakfast. That means he never said 2 times, but he says avoid breakfast. So once you avoid breakfast, you are going to have lunch and dinner only. So what was happening? Now, if you look at the medical fraternity, they say breakfast is the main meal or important meal, they say. I tell you, this is a myth. Who will benefit by eating breakfast? The cereal company, the food industry developer makes it. If I say eat only twice, there's no benefit to the food industry, isn't it? If they say eat every 2 hours, keep on munching, keep on eating. That's how it is been misled. That particular doctor has done amazing. That there is a particular video I have, I can share with you, friends. And he has done in 1901, that means almost 120 years ago, the technology is there, but it is not spreading into the mainline audience because, you know, there is no benefit for the industry. eating twice, food has not come here. Minimum 7 hours sleep is very important, friends. A lot of people sleep 5 hours, 4 hours. No, you need to sleep 7 hours because this is the only thing you gets you the energy, and that is also important. 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. A lot of people sleep at 1 o'clock and get up at 9 o'clock. Not at all good. If you get up at 9 o'clock, you will miss drinking water, you miss doing the exercise, you miss going to the toilet and all that. Don't do that. Just back to 10 to 5 a.m. is the good one. Mind management. See, how do we do the mind management? Because human, only the, if you look at animals and humans, all are requiring common requirements. See, let us say 7 essentials. All of you know, people who are attending Manthana programs, they know there are 7 essentials for good health. If you don't have that, you will go into trouble. What are the 7 essentials? First and foremost is the air, the breath. Fortunately, it is not in our control. If it is in our control, we would have forgotten. God has kept in his control, so you are breathing without anybody's intervention. Next most important, if you don't breathe for 3 minutes, 4 minutes, you're dead. But still you're living because it's not under your control. Next is water. It is under our control. We make a mess of it. If you don't drink water for about 3-4 days, no water is given to you. People will die. Right? Very important. Third is food. If you don't eat for 30 days, 40 days also, people will survive. So food is not such an important thing. Three. Fourth is exercise. See, we think, what is exercise? Look at in animal kingdom. In animal kingdom, food hunting is an exercise for it. It doesn't require any special exercise. Every animal, suppose animal has got 10 children also, but that animal has to run for its own food. Nobody comes and hands over. For a human being, you get your breakfast on your lap, lunch on your table, dinner also can come onto your bed. So no exercise is needed. So people have become habituated to simply remain idle. Why animal kingdom is absolutely healthy? Because they have to hunt for food. I was shocked to learn elephant travels about some 30-40 kilometers, I believe, for food in a day. 30-40 kilometers. Surprising, I never knew that. Look at a dog. It will not be staying there. It will be running around here and there. It doesn't require any exercise. Only domesticated dogs, where you tie at home, they develop all the same problems like human beings. I was shocked the other day to know dogs also have diabetes, dogs have BP, dogs also don't have vision problem, cataract, all that. It is because they are friends to us. We are teaching what nonsense we do to them. Look at the animals, free animals, they have no issues. There is no problems to them. All right. Now, we talked about exercise. Four, we covered air, water, and food. Fourth, we covered exercise. What would be the fifth one? Fifth one is the excretion, removal of the waste from your body. You have got 4 organs to remove your waste from your body. The most first organ is your toilet, then the urine, then the sweat from the skin. The fourth is from your nostrils, lungs. You breathe out the air always. So these are the 4 excretion organs we have. You have to keep them perfectly all right. Say friends, in your house, you have a outlet to go the wastewater. If the outlet gets blocked, what happens? If your kitchen outlet gets blocked, your kitchen gets smelly. Your toilet outlet gets blocked, you will not be able to enter your bathroom. Similarly, make sure that your 4 outlets are absolutely kept clean and all the waste are removed. Excretion is the fourth one. Fifth one. What is the next one? The rest. What is rest? When we say rest means sleeping. Yes, but giving rest to your internal organs. If you eat food before 7 o'clock, you have a lot of time for the rest to your internal organs. So it's very important to finish your dinner before 7 o'clock. Rest. So these all 6 are common. Air, water, food, exercise, excretion, rest. All 6 are common for the human and animals. No change. Everything should happen. Human being has a mind. So he has an extra organ, he has that mind. If you don't keep the mind properly, you get into the psychosomatic problems. So that's how people have to maintain their thought process, calmness, and how to manage your emotions and all that. So as I explained to you, mind management is very important. How do we do that? I have done a program called Isha Inner Engineering Program. Amazing program. It helps you to take care of your life, avoid stress, and meditation, you can do that. Now look at the sixth point is the food. In your getting to good health, sixth is the food. Remember that. Most of the people think food is more important. Not at all. Eat only twice in a day when you are hungry and maintain the same timings. Nothing in between except water. As I explained to you, friends, even your favorite god comes and offers you a prasadam, keep it with you, don't eat it. If you follow this simple technique, just watch my word, next 3 months you would be a transformed person. If one is keen for good health, eat one time uncooked food before 7 p.m. What is uncooked food? Why we should eat uncooked food? Because once you cook the food, all the vitamins and the enzymes will get lost. So these are all the things. We'll share some photographs next time. Vegetable juice. Mantena group knows everything. Sprouts, soaked groundnuts, soaked almonds, fresh coconut nuts. I'll just show you a simple photograph for you guys. Seventh point is fasting once in a fortnight with honey and lemon water. See, you're eating only 2 times food. 15 days once you can do the fasting. It's an amazing technique by Dr. Mantena. Other people have a different approach for fasting, but in Mantena program, I remember Dr. Vaila, when she was there, she did fasting for about 20 days or 25 days, if I remember. Amazing benefit she has got. Fasting once in a fortnight is the best thing. The eighth point is the one very important, friends. Avoidance of, this is what I said, toxins. All these first points are telling you what is needed. What is needed, you are doing. All these 7 points, you are doing what is needed. So there is no deficiency. Now, this is the toxins. You have to avoid that. What are the avoidance you have to do? Coffee, probably all of your liking things, huh? Coffee, tea, alcohol, tobacco. These are the stimulants. In long run, they are not good. Not good at all. Avoid or reduce. I'm using the word reduce. Avoiding is the best. But reduce, I'm not saying you to stop it. Reduce it. Like sweets, bakery items, junk food, refined and packaged food. Remember, friends, in US and any place, every food is a refined packed food. It's manufactured in the factory. Food manufactured in the factory, that means you have to be inviting diseases. Avoid reduced salt, refined oils, and non-vegetarian foods. So a lot of people feel that non-vegetarian is good, a lot of protein and all that. In the long run, it is not good, friends. Once in a while you want to have, it's all right, but avoid that. Look at these 8 points. If these are the golden rules I'm saying, if you just follow these points, the benefits, the examples, what you have seen, two gentlemen who have shown the photographs and others have benefited, they have also shared, which I'm not sharing here. These are the 7 points to be, 8 points to be kept in mind. And the ninth, these are the key health parameters. See, many times we go to a doctor, they say comprehensive health checkup. And they charge you some $3,000-$4,000 and they do some 30-40 tests. Unfortunately, most critical tests, they don't do that. I just want to share one small example. I was in Mantena Arogyalayam. This one guy came there. He was weighing about 102 kg weight and he's 35 years. Incidentally, I'm 62 and he was not able to run along with me. Of course, walk along with me. And 32 years, I asked him, what is the problem? No, sir, no problem. I just came to reduce weight, 102 kg weight. He says he has got knee pain and all that. Then I said, what about your blood report? He says, no, I got it done, sir. My nephew got it done in Hyderabad. All the reports are perfect. I said, surprising. If all the reports are perfect, why are you like this? There may be something wrong. You are definitely not all right. You have a problem, but your comprehensive health checkup is not telling you any problem. That means you have not picked up the right points. Friends, let me tell you what are the key tests to be done. These are very important tests. As I explained to you, fasting insulin test is very important. Fasting sugar is very important too. PP insulin. Because it is needed only for the people who are in an advanced stage of diabetes and all that. Otherwise, this is not required. HbA1c is needed. Lipid profile, where you can check your triglycerides and the good cholesterol and all that. D-vitamin test is very important. It should be above 30. And there are two more things. You just check your BP, blood pressure, how much it should be, between 120 by 80. And your weight, you should not be obese. And another point is that your waist size. There's one more point, I think I'll just show it to you. Wait a minute. Oh. See here, these are the three things. Fasting insulin should be 3 to 5. Make a note of it. Fasting sugar should be below 99. It's healthy ranges they are. PP insulin after 2 hours, it should be below 30. HbA1c below 5.6. For below 5 is the best anybody has. Then you can work it out, the your insulin resistance. If it is below 1.5 is good. Mild insulin means this is the 1.5 to 2.9. Moderate is 3 to 5. Severe means above 5. I've just shared some of my friends' insulin resistance, how this insulin resistance is the main cause for obesity and diabetes. Lipid profile, this is again, you can check your insulin, I mean, cholesterol levels. There is one particular criteria, triglycerides to HDL ratio, it should be 1, plus minus 0.5. D vitamin, it should be above 30. I'm telling you, friends, you can take it granted, 80% of the humanity are having D vitamin deficiency. The question is that we are exposed to the sun even then, because the main reason is most of us, we are drinking RO water. RO water is one big criteria for D vitamin deficiency. And of course, your food habits and your soil quality, the produce, how the quality is happening, what sort of nutritious food is coming out, all that. Blood pressure should be 90 to 60 to 120 by 80. It should be best is between these two. Height to weight ratio, this is what BMI, 18.5 to 24.5. Then height to waist ratio. See, many people think is very important, waist size. Suppose it is actually half of the size of your height by the inches. Suppose you are 5 feet 6 inches. That means you are 66 inches. Your waist should be below 33. I used to have my waist is 36. Now my waist is about 33. For the last 6 years. Oh, I wanted to show you. See, this is the vegetable juice and sprouts. This is how you can make the sprouts. One time food should be like this. I think Mantena group already following sprouts, pomegranate, and then you have papaya, and you have soaked sesame seeds, you have dates, you have some dry fruits, you have soaked badam and the groundnut, coconut, any type of food, and similarly. So last 6 years, 90% of my time I have one time of this food, which is giving me a great advantage. This is a vegetable juice. I think most of the things. I can tell you a simple technique of smoothie. We'll talk in the next probably session. This is what I wanted to share with you, friends. Oh, this is what I want to show it to you. My nephew, who's about 22-year-old, he was in Chennai. He's about almost 81 kg weight. And I asked him, I took him to the blood test. And look at his fasting sugar is 92. The best, the great. And HbA1c is 5.5, super. If this guy takes only these two readings and go to the doctor, he will tell him, he'll say, Sabash, you're doing a fantastic job. And when I got his insulin checked, it is 24.49, friends. Look at it, 24.49. It should be below 5. He's almost 5 times high. He's 81 kg weight, right? He's unable to shed his weight. Why? Because he's already having 5.56 is severe insulin resistance. If this guy continues his lifestyle, next say 4 or 5 years, he is a sure candidate for a diabetes. Similar thing had happened. My niece, who was in Nigeria. Yeah, she was in Kenya, I think. Yeah, she came on a holiday with her two daughters. She was 41 years. I used to share all the information to her. She told me, "Uncle, why now? We will also do at your age." I said, "Great." She came for 2 days visit to India. So she was in Andhra. I told my brother, "Pack her and daughters to that lab and get this test done." Surprisingly, my niece, who had never had a problem, her HbA1c was 8.5. She's already full-grown diabetic. She didn't know. And she got devastated and she started treatment. And my niece, one girl was 21, another girl is about 16 years, both had tremendous insulin levels. They're already already obese. They already have PCOD problem. They have problems on, difficult periods and then painful periods and all that. I said, what nonsense is this? 16 years, 22 years, high insulin levels, but they are good. The sugar levels are all right. They have not yet come to sugar levels. So friends, it is necessary for all of you to see. See, whenever I ask somebody, no, no, sir, I don't have sugar, I don't need this. Unfortunately, let's understand, sugar is not at all a point to be discussed. We need to look at where you are on insulin resistance. Just wanted to share you this. And okay, there are a few diets, the successful diets. You all know Manthina Natural Lifestyle Diet. Dr. Manthina, he's talking about 7 essentials for good health. And his technique, I'm telling you, the best technique, like the VRK diet. Dr. Dixit, right? I was telling you, gentlemen, that Dr. Dixit also doing, his also technique is simple, eat only twice. Everybody, all these 6 diets are successful. Why? You know the reason. Nobody's talking about junk food. Nobody's talking about processed food. Nobody's talking about number of times eating. Everybody is telling eat twice, eat when you're hungry. So all that takeaway from this lecture will be, just don't, for the heck of it, don't shove it in the mouth. There's one lady which I came to know, she eats very less. She says, no, sir, I eat very less. But what she does, whenever she's cooking, she had a lot of guests, I believe. Whenever she's cooking, she keeps tasting it. Believe me, friends, you put a small morsel in the mouth, it's amount to eating only. It amounts to digestion. So avoid that. Avoid that. Yeah, I just said to resources, Dr. Manthina, my guru, great guy, and all of them, Dr. Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev, I was talking to you about Isha program. Listen to these videos. I have made one, Wellness Secrets. It's a write-up, a small write-up with about 15 video links. And these video links I have chosen after my intense study of 6 years. I have picked up, re-edited, I picked up this 15, 16 video links, friends. If you look at these 15, 16 video links and understand that, what all I have spent time in 6 years, you can learn in a span of 2-3 days. Don't you think it is wonderful? Pay attention, read that. That's all what I want to tell you, friends. Knowledge and practice are the gateways to your health. By following the above mentioned things, you can surely overcome all your health problems. Thank you very much. Thanks for patient listening. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, uncle. Thank you.
Dr. Vaila.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Some people are asking questions. I don't know if you can take questions.
Yeah. I can. We can.
Yeah. Someone asked, how do you ensure at least 2 bowel movements every day?
I think the simple technique. See, for all of you, I'll send that write-up. There are three write-ups, two on PDF form, another one is on the PowerPoint, which I'll share to Dr. Vaila. You can go through. Very simple technique, I'll tell you, for 2 bowel movement. It doesn't happen immediately over a period of time. Start hydration. Drink 3 to 4 liters of water regularly, as I explained to you, the process. See, the best technique, Dr. Manthina's amazing technique, which I didn't know. I learned only at the age of 56. I feel very bad. Youngsters in this group, you are lucky to learn this and start at the early age. Let me tell you, my grandson, who is 5-year-old, another grandson is 1-year-old. They just go toilet in no time in the morning, and then we go out for a walking. So what is the technique? Let's understand this. See, I'll go to the slide and explain to you. Yeah. Okay. See, look at it. I think we'll spend proper hydration. See, morning, see what happens is that 2 to 2.5 liters water gets out of your body every day. How some water will get lost in your urine. Some will go into your toilet, into your stools, and some will go in the sweat, and some will go through your inhalation and exhalation. That means 2 to 2.5 liters water is getting wasted from your body every day. Suppose if you are not replenishing it, minimum 3 to 4 liters, you are on a constant dehydration. As I explained to you, friends, if you don't drink sufficient water, your body can reabsorb the water from your bowels. That's how people who have got constipation, their stools are becoming hard because the water has reabsorbed. And if the stools remain in the body for long, it gets you know more solidified. So what is the technique? Let's look at this technique. We can spend some more time. Immediately after getting up, you got up from the bed, please don't, even your God is coming and tapping the door asking you to offer the heaven, ask him to wait. You get up, go and drink water. 1 to 1.25 liters water you drink, warm water. Drink the water, 1.25 liters. Focus your attention on your stomach. Focus your attention on stomach. Think about going to the toilet only. Don't engage in any other activity. If you're engaging watching TV or news or probably a mobile phone or anything, or just talking to your spouse, your system will not work. Don't deviate anything. Focus on your stomach and walk inside. 10-15 minutes later, when it becomes urgent, go to the toilet. Then you can go to the toilet. In the toilet also, don't engage in watching mobile or paper and all that. Finish your toilet. It's very important. The first toilet should happen like that. Right? Pardon? What happens is that, one more point, let me add up. See what happens if you see the construction of your stomach. I'll just show you. See, look at this stomach here. This stomach, what happens when you, this is the stomach, see this one, this is the stomach. See, once you put the morning 1 to 1.25 liters water, your stomach is empty because you did not eat through overnight. So this water will fall on this. This is transverse colon. This colon, it's called. It is actually not fixed. It is flexible like a jhula, like a swing. Once it falls on it, there will be a movement. And then you will feel become urgent. See, if you look at it, you know, people who have children, in the morning, you know, children, they will not be able to go to the toilet on their own. So what parents will do to send them to the school, they will immediately brush him and then feed him the food. And they put the dress and all. By the time the school bus come, he said, no, I want to go to the toilet. You know, what happened there? Because it, food has gone into the stomach and it is just falling onto his colon. That's how he wants to go to the toilet. So the same technique we are applying here by putting in the water, not the food. By putting the water, 1 to 1.25 liters water in the stomach, this would help in bowel movement. This is the first step one should do. Remember one thing, friends. It's not only the weight, it is the intention. See, many times, if you are feeling urgent to go to the toilet, because say there is no facility, what happens? You have a control, you have a mind control. You can hold it, right? Similarly, so it's necessary in the morning to focus both. Drink water, focus on stomach. So first toilet, you should go like that. Then you do the at least 45 minutes walk or exercise or any game. Then come back. At least you give a gap of 1 to 1.5 hours gap between first water intake and second water intake. Say for example, 6 o'clock you drank water and you went to the toilet and you went for a walk and all, 7:30 you come back. Again drink 1 to 1.25 liter water. Same process. You will be able to excrete. Initially people who have got the health problems, I mean in the sense they have not had this habit quite some time, they can start enema. Take that enema kit and you can do administering at home only, and over a period 3-4 days time it will become clear. And then once you become clean, you see, you will feel as you are walking, probably are flying. You don't walk. I have the same feeling always. So I don't walk on the ground. I'm always 2 feet above the ground in terms of floating range. That can only happen if the bowel movement takes place, right? Yeah. Any other question? Is it clear about the bowel movement?
Yeah. Yes. Thank you for that response. We have two more questions.
Yeah.
The second one is from Satya. He asked, which water is safe to drink?
Okay. See, presently, RO water, if you have this TDS is above, say, 100, is good actually. Presently, what RO water comes, the TDS is the, you know, particles and all that, is about 40-50 comes. Don't worry about it. My suggestion would be just add a small pinch of rock salt in the water before you're drinking. A small pinch of rock salt. That would help you. That would help you, the D vitamin. For D vitamin... Yeah. Is that clear? Water, don't get too much of worried. You can drink any water, probably clean and filtered water. drink it, and then just add a little pinch of rock salt. That would help.
Okay, yeah. And another person asks, can water affect vitamin D levels?
What is that? Come again?
Can water affect the vitamin D level?
What level is that?
Vitamin D. Can water?
Oh, yeah, yeah, D vitamin. D, yeah, yeah, it should be about 30. D vitamin should be above 30. There is a range there. There is one particular criteria is there. Most of the people have below. It should be above 30.
Okay, I think that's all the questions sent.
Thank you very much, and God bless you, and wish you all good health. And I'll share. Anybody can call on my number. Thank you very much. Thank you, Bhagavad.
Yeah, thank you so much. Namaste.
Namaste. Did somebody want to ask a question?
Yeah. I have a question.
Yeah. Okay, okay, go on.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah. That this concept that too much water is not good for the body. What they call water intoxication.
Okay.
Water intoxication. So okay. That, see,